Hello, this is the Provoked Prawn, and this is the NZXT C750. This is a 750-watt modular power supply unit from NZXT, and in this video I'm going to show you how to go about the installation process for this power supply and the various steps. Now, this is a modular device, which means that you only need to plug in the cables that you actually want to use, which is pretty handy. And it's also interesting because it has a zero RPM button on the back there that you can press, which means the fan won't spin unless it's required. Now, the power supply unit is interestingly and usefully labelled at the rear where all the plug holes are, which means that it's fairly straightforward in terms of what you plug in and where, but in this video I'm going to show you where you plug them in and what they're used for. Now, everything that you need is included in the purple bag. In there you'll find the main power supply that obviously plugs into the wall, all the various cables and the screws for screwing it into your case. Now, the first and most important power supply cable that you need to plug in is the 24-pin. Cable for your motherboard. This is split into two parts but plugs in the top left corner, and you can't plug it in anywhere else. You will need this one to be plugged into your motherboard in order for your PC to run. It is the most important cable, and you can see that on the motherboard it generally plugs in on the right hand side, and it's difficult to get to and fiddly to plug in. There's a little clip along the side of it that you'll see jutting out. And the cable itself also has a little clip that hooks over the edge of that, so it requires a little bit of force once it's inside your case. Now, you will also find that there are some CPU power supply cables that are required as well. These are 8-pin, and this will vary from motherboard to motherboard, but you'll find that on the thing they're actually labeled conveniently, one end says PSU and the other end says CPU. These plug in where it's CPU marked on the power supply unit, so you can't really get it wrong. And obviously you plug in the PSU end into the power supply unit, and then the CPU end goes into your motherboard. Now, these can be some of the fiddliest ones to do, because you'll often find there's not much space at the top of your case when you finish building to plug them in. They generally plug into the top left corner, though it's worth checking your motherboard manual to make sure, because sometimes it varies from manufacturer to manufacturer. But you can see that I've got two up here in the top left that will be required to plug in on this MSI motherboard. The 24-pin and these two 8-pin CPU power cables are necessary to power the CPU and the motherboard and make sure it has enough power. The next is the flat Sata power connectors. These are daisy chainable, and you'll see that they plug in on the bottom left. Now, these are used for a variety of different things, and they have multiple connections per cable, which means that you can actually plug in several different things to the same cable. They're used for all sorts of things, from all-in-one pump heads, so Kraken Z63 in this example, plugging that in there, that has a flat connection. They're also used for fan control hubs, so you can see NZXT's smart fan hub here. It also works with Corsair's Commander Pro, Commander Core, and things like that as well. So same sort of logic. And as you can see, you can just plug it in. You can't get it the wrong way around because they're L-shaped on the inside, but they're flat and they're all very similar. This cable also plugs in to any SSDs or HDDs that you have in your case as well. So if you've got SSDs or hard disk drives that need plugging in and connecting, then these are the cables that you will use. As I said already, you can daisy chain them up, so you can connect multiple drives up to one cable that plugs into your power supply, and then it's just a case of plugging them in at the rear. And this is obviously one of the connections. The other one is the data connection, which then goes to your motherboard. But you'll see it works the same way for both traditional platter-based hard drives and solid-state drives as well, so the same sort of connection applies for both. The next is the PCIe cables. Now, these are generally used for, obviously, your graphics card, and they may have other uses too. PCIe connection plugs in where the PCIe marks are on the power supply unit, and they come in two different forms, essentially a split in a slightly different power setup, and the reason for this is they may have different uses. You can see on this motherboard, for example, there's one 6-pin power connection at the bottom of the motherboard, which also needs plugging in, and you'll note it says PCIe power 1, and this is extra power for the motherboard to power essential things that it needs to in terms of the PCIe power. So you plug in that cable and run it through and plug it into the bottom. But what you'll notice is that there are multiple connections on here for PCIe power, and that's because you will find that some graphics cards require sometimes two or three 8-pin power connections. You can see that my 3090, for example, has two 8-pin connections. For note, if you're wondering why the white cables are there, that's cable mod cables that are attached to the end. They're extension of cables, essentially, just to make things look a bit nicer. The next cable is the Molex cable. Now, this is used for peripherals and extra things, and you'll notice it has these chunky sort of clips on either side of it, so it's easy to identify. And this is essentially used for things like liquid cooling pumps, so if you've got a full system like that, and other sort of older peripherals. Generally don't find that you have to use that in most modern builds. Obviously, once you've got all the cables installed, and I would recommend plugging the cables in that you're going to use before you put it in your case, then you can install it with the included screws. Doing this means that you don't have to work your hand into the case and try and force the cables in when you can't really see what slots are going where. It makes life a lot easier, and it also means that the cable management is a bit simpler. There are four screws included in the box that you can use to screw the power supply into the case. You might also find that you have similar screws included with your case, depending on what manufacturer you got it from. Here you can see me doing it in the NZXT H510 flow. The next step is obviously to then run the cables through the various cable channeling parts of the case and into the right direction. So obviously I need to run the two 8-pin CPU power cables up to the top so that I can then access those and plug them into the top of the motherboard once I've installed that. These aren't going anywhere, so you can use cable ties to hold them in place and then work them through. Now, the cables are quite fiddly and quite chunky and quite difficult to maneuver around. And you saw earlier on that I used cable mod attachments on some other PSU cables. These are essentially extension leads that are a bit easier to negotiate around things. But these are obviously all still usable, and they have a nice sort of thick cabling on them, so they're very good quality. And make sure that you run them into the right direction. So obviously the 24 pin needs to go roughly into the middle of where that's going to connect up to the side of your motherboard, and then you can start to sort out all the cables in there. And then once you've done that, obviously plug it in and turn it on, and there you have your built PC. Obviously, this is a few steps removed. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Thanks for watching. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Hope you found this video useful, interesting, hilarious, or otherwise. Take a look at these other videos that I think you might find interesting as well. And have a look at the description for links and other information you might find useful. Click that join button to see the benefits of being a member of my YouTube channel. And most importantly, have a great life.